Hey guys, it's Power in Your Curl, and I'm so excited for today's video because Mayel Organics has a brand new line, and it's called the Mungongo Oil Collection. And this line is geared towards your curly hair and your heat styled hair. So I'm gonna go ahead and prep my hair to be shampooed, and I'm gonna start by pre-pooing. So the line comes with a pre-shampoo treatment, and I've used it a few times before this video, and I found that it works better for me to actually apply coconut oil first. That way I can go through my entire head and remove as many tangles and shed hairs as possible. And then I'm gonna go in with the Mayel Organics pre-shampoo treatment. Now, this product smells so good. It's super minty and it just smells really light and fresh, and it works really, really well. So if you need to give your hair some more moisture and just condition it and soften it up a little bit before you shampoo, this is gonna be the product for you. Now, I like the texture of it a lot. It has like a serum texture to it, and that makes it easier to put throughout your hair, especially when it's been a couple of days since your last wash day and it's a little bit tangled. So this product does work really well, but it's only 5 fluid ounces big. And because I have so much hair, it just helps for me to put an oil in my hair first to make the product last a little bit longer. So I'm gonna put a shower cap on and let this product sit for about 30 minutes just so it can penetrate my hair a little bit before we jump in the shower. So here's what my hair looks like after I let the treatment and the oil sit on my hair for about 30 to 45 minutes. And now I'm gonna go ahead and shampoo my hair. So I'm gonna wet my hair down and then apply the exfoliating shampoo from the Mungongo Oil line. And this shampoo smells so good as well. This whole line smells like old-fashioned, old-school natural hair products, but better, just way better. You have to smell it to know what I'm talking about. So this shampoo lathers really, really well, and it does clean your hair really well. This is a clarifying shampoo, so you don't want to use this every week. I usually clarify my hair every 3 to 5 weeks, just depending on what my hair needs. So when I'm shampooing my hair, I like to concentrate on the roots and then drag the product down the length of my hair so I can get rid of the product buildup on my scalp as well as the length of my hair. And then I go ahead and rinse out the shampoo. And now I'm gonna move on to the hydrating conditioner. So this is a protein-free conditioner, and it's very thick, a lot thicker than the Mint Babassu Oil Deep Conditioner, if you're familiar with that. So I just applied the conditioner to my hair along with my favorite detangling conditioner, and then I'm gonna go ahead and detangle. So once I finish detangling, I move on to deep conditioning. Now I did try the Mungongo Oil Conditioner as a deep conditioner before this video, and it didn't really work that well, especially considering how good the Babassu Oil Mint Deep Conditioner is. So I'm just gonna stick to what I know and use that as my deep conditioner today. And then to enhance my deep conditioning process, I'm going to use the pomade to oil treatment. And usually when I want to do an extreme deep condition, I'll apply Jamaican black castor oil on top of my deep conditioner. So today I'm going to take the pomade to oil, and it has a very soft texture. And once you rub your hands together, it completely turns into oil. So it's really weird, but really cool. I've never used a product like this before. So I'm just going to apply the pomade to oil to my ends and also along the length of my hair just to lock in my deep conditioner. And I ended up deep conditioning with these products overnight. And when I rinsed my hair out in the morning with cool water, my hair was really moisturized and really bouncy. So now we're gonna move on to the styling process. And I wanna try something a little bit different today. I wanna do blow-dried wand curls. So the first step is to blow dry my hair. And the first product I'm gonna be using is the Style Setting Spray. So this product is really good for indirect heatless styles like flexi rod sets or elongated bantu knot sets. And I'm gonna be using it to act as a detangler and a moisturizer before I blow dry my hair. So I'm just going to spray it in my hair, and then I'm going to part the section that I'm gonna braid a little bit later. And then I'm just gonna take my wide tooth comb and thoroughly detangle my hair one more time just to make sure there are no knots and so that my hair won't get tangled while I'm blow drying. And here I just took a little bit more of that pomade to oil treatment and applied it to my ends and the length of my hair just to lock in some of that moisture. And that actually ended up being a mistake because when I was blow drying, the pomade to oil was just turning into like a linty gunk residue on the bottom of my hair. So I wouldn't recommend putting the pomade to oil treatment in your hair before you blow dry. It might be better to use the pomade to oil treatment as a finisher just for some shine and some hold. So now I'm going to go ahead and cornrow that section and braid it all the way down. And then I'm just going to repeat the same steps on the top portion of my head. So the reason why I'm braiding my hair before I blow dry it is just so that I can minimize the amount of heat that I have to use during the blow dry process. So by braiding my hair, I'm stretching my curl pattern, and I'm also just letting it air dry for about 3 hours before I go in with the blow dryer. That way my hair isn't soaking wet. So I'm gonna let my hair dry until it's about damp and then show you how I blow dry. So I'm just going to unbraid the section back there. And the good thing about making these braids is because I put them in smaller sections, I already have the sections that I'm gonna use to blow dry. And I'm just gonna go through and detangle my hair one more time, just getting rid of all the waves and the curl pattern that the braid caused. And then I'm gonna take the heat protectant from this line. And I really like this heat protectant. It's kind of like a detangler as well because it has a milky and moisturizing texture. And the packaging on all of these products in the Mungongo line is just so pretty. I love the metallic pink. So I'm just spraying the heat protectant all over that section, and I'm starting to pull my hair down to put some tension on it so I can prepare it for the blow dryer, because as I blow dry, I pull my hair just to create that tension and make it easier for it to get straight. So here is what my hair looks like fully blow dried. I feel like Queen Mother Goddess right now with all this hair. But as you can see, my hair is pretty shiny and it also feels really lightweight. The products do a good job of moisturizing your hair without weighing it down. And I also like that my hair isn't frizzy. So now we're gonna move into the very last step, which is wanding my hair. And I'm just gonna take a slim 1-inch section to start. And after I make sure all the tangles and knots are completely free out of this section, I'm gonna go ahead and split that in half and wand the smaller section. So this was my very first time wanding my hair. So this video isn't a tutorial, I'm just showing you guys how I did it. And I'm using a 1/2 inch to 1 inch wand on 266 degrees because that's the lowest that the wand would go. And I'll leave links and the names of all the hot tools that I used in this video down below. But I'm just going to cup the curl in my hand and let it cool down before I let it drop. That way it doesn't drop too much when I first wand it. And I like to just keep my hair on the wand for about 20 to 25 seconds. And again, cupping the curl to let it cool. This is the happy dance because this is the very last curl. This wash day styling session was 2 days long, so I was just really happy that it was over. So these are the results of my hair before I separate and fluff. And then this is what my hair looks like after I separate everything and kind of just fluff it out with my fingers. I think the definition came out really good, and I think the heat protectant spray and the style setting spray had a lot to do with that. Overall, I'm pretty happy with this line. I think it's really cool that there's a natural option for products when you want to heat style your hair. The only thing I didn't like was how small the pre-shampoo treatment was. But thank you guys so much for watching. If you're new here, go ahead and subscribe by clicking on my face right there in the bottom left-hand corner. And if you guys are interested in seeing more from me, I have some videos linked here for you on the screen. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next one.